Woohoo!
Huh? Ah!
Hey guys, this is Jim, and welcome to episode 2 of O3 Minecraft, our 1.10.2 modded Minecraft series. How you going, guys? Did you like the first episode?
I'm so super excited about this world, yay!
Always good when you start a new world, isn't it, guys? You sort of really get into it and things. Normally we'll sort of alternate this series with Obs Explore, with Obs Worlds, with an occasional Obs Explore thrown in. But for today, we're going to keep going with this one. I want to keep going. There's things we need to do. So, since last episode, I've picked up some more armor from mobs, basically. Zombies and skellies dropping things. So I've got a little bit of armor. We've got these over here. Now, we saw these crystals from Future Pack in the last episode. So basically, I just put down some of the sand there. And it's growing the crystals. I harvested a whole lot before. And I went mining and found basically another similar thing to where we found this, but a different colour. So an aleutine sand, and this one grows aleutine crystals. So a similar thing. So I gather there might be a few different types of these little crystal things in Future Pack. Very much leaning towards doing Future Pack, guys. Not today, but very, 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 very soon. Also, just a few more crops and things. Got those little wormy guys going around. Some of the crops and things there. This chest is a topaz chest. So there's a mod called Gemulation. Gemulation. It's an add-on for Silence Gems, basically. And you can use the gems to make furnaces, chests, crafting tables, and these little bags as well. So these little bags, basically when you go mining, it'll pick up all the gems that you mine. So very handy. So when I was doing, I did some more mining too since last episode. I think I mentioned that, didn't I, guys? yes, so we've got even more ores now. Haven't actually smelted any up yet, but we've got plenty of ores there ready to go. Another gemulation chest thing. Yes, furnace, this one. Basically with these furnaces, when you put the fuel in, it fills up this little fuel bar here, and then you can actually, looks like you can put some upgrades in there too. I'm not sure what that's about yet though. I've got a crafting table here from Little Insignificant Things. It's basically a crafting table where you can put things in it and they don't drop. So a bit like the Tinker's crafting station. So that's quite a nice little thing there too. What else have we got here? Oh, this green chest here, a jungle chest from Dark Utilities. So just normal sized chest, but a different little pattern on it there. It looks quite nice too. What else? Plenty of stuff from Future Pack. I found another one of those little structure things. So I got some more goodies from Future Pack. And we got this in the last episode. This e-scanner. And if you click it, it opens this. And so you can click it on blocks. So there we clicked on the stone. But things like this. Look at this tech tree. So looking very, looks very similar to the Thorncraft, doesn't it? If you know about Thorncraft. So we've got all these things here to do. So space travel. Ooh. So I'm thinking, guys, Future Pack will be something we're going to do in probably the next episode. But today we're going to go. We're going to go out there somewhere. We're going to go a-wandering. Hello, Mr. Troll. Oh, there you go. So he was in the shade. Then he hit the sun. And he froze. So they do freeze in the sun, those guys. Aha. There you go. Yes. You interrupted me, Mr. Troll. We're going exploring, basically, guys. But first, rather than explore the overworld, we're going to go, obsidian, we're going to go explore the Nether. So we'll get a few goodies together and we'll go jump into the Nether. Okay, let's go. Now, I've got this here, small Bedouin extra dimensional space nomadic tents. But that's for the overworld travel. Let's go to the Nether first. Now, I don't know that I've actually added anything explicit for the Nether, as in anything that adds much to the Nether, so I'm not sure what we'll find. Ooh, there's lots of ores and things I can see. Yeah, I don't know if there's ever gonna be any mobs or anything other than vanilla stuff. Like him. Like him. Hey. Oh yeah, don't spam click. these guys. But there's lots of ores here, that's for sure. You, and then you guys are just really annoying. Get out of the way. Oop. And if you can see my tools there, guys, I've used Silence Gems tools pretty much for all my tools here. And there's Nether Lapisaur from Cyclic. Okay, so regular ores here in the Nether. Black coal ore. Okay. What else? It looks like gold over here, doesn't it? Lapis gold. Okay. Is there any sort of other ores, like non-vanilla stuff? There's a thing down there. What is that? It's a thing. Well, looks like diamond there. Nice. What are you, Mr. Thing? Are you all happy? We won't attack you. You're just going to be happy. What are you? Salamander from Quintessential Creatures. Aha! Hello, Mr. Salamander. Okay. I've got a nether fortress over there. That'll be handy. What else? Lapis? Something? Oh, yes. Tinker's thingy over there. All right. Let's, oh, there's another salamander up there. Why don't we sort of head over towards the nether fortress there, see if there's anything interesting in that. Oh, magma blocks. Look at that. Vanilla. Lots of yellow things there, too. We'll have to take a look at that. Hopefully we can find one that's accessible somewhere. And blazes. Blazes. Diamonds. Ooh, that looks very handy. Oh, emeralds. There you go. What else? Ugh. Just you guys who are... No. We don't really have fire protection here, do we, yet? Uh-oh. Oh, man. Yeah, good one, Jim. Alright, I think I've got my stuff, guys. I'm pretty lucky there. Didn't lose too much. In the end, might have lost one of these wardrobes from Future Pack. I bring those along to put stuff in, given that you can break them without having to drop the stuff. Yeah, so anyway, after my incompetence there. So, Silence Gems, looks like it adds a few gems to the nether here. Probably, are they ones probably that you can't get in the overworld? And as you saw there, they sort of disappeared. So they go straight into this gemulation little bag there. So we've got Violet Sapphire. Woohoo, very nice. So I'm basically just like the normal nether, but looking like we've just got lots of ores. Lots and lots and lots of ores. Pigmen, salamanders. That might be about the extent of the differences, I think. Yeah, lots of ores. So I'm going to have to do lots of mining. But we'll head over into that guy, into the nether fortress there, and take a look in there, I think. Ooh, hang on. What's this? I better show you this one, guys. Obs Machines, Helonium Ore. So, yes, Obs Machines does add an ore into the nether. Yes. I have plans for it, guys. Plans. And Obs Machines also adds something else, which we'll look at when we see it. Okay, finally. So, there's a spawner over there for... Oops. and it's dark. For blazes. Them things, yes. Okay. And by the way, I've got this little guy too, guys. Crafting on a stick. This is from Actually Editions, a little handy portable crafting table. Okay, let's see if we find anything a bit different in here. Certainly heaps of ores for us. Yeah. Looking sort of pretty normal at the moment, isn't it? Oop, first chest. What do we got? Ooh, it's some... Molten cores from Reliquary. Paris... Blah, 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 action figure. Right-click in air to change gender. Aha! Tyrannosaurus action figure. Action figures. Random things. A lava charm. Ooh, lava charm. I wonder if that's going to give us... Ooh, fire charm. Fire protection while carrying. From Cyclic. Diamonds. Skull for Gallimus. A record. Oh, a record. And copper, 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 copper. And another record. Ah, very cool. Okay, can you notice on our GUI there above our armor, we've got those little fire things. So we've got a lava charm from random things and a fire charm from cyclic. If we drop one of those down, okay, so maybe it's the lava charm here from random things. Can we put it in a bauble slot? We can. Okay. What about this one? What about this? Do we put this in a bauble slot? We can too. Fire charm, lava charm. All right, we might have to see how we go, especially against some of those blazes. Oop, nether wart. We'll need that. I just broke the nether wart, and some of them dropped this infernal bulb from roots. So there's another mod we've got to play with. Another chest with some more skulls, action figures. Oh, ender wing, teleport to world spawn. And a green apple, emerald apple. Unlocks villager trades or cures zombie villagers. Ah, redstone crystals, biome crystals from Randall. All sorts of goodies. Wither skellies. Whoop. 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 Oh, and a skelly, and these guys. Oh, and you guys fight. There we go. Good, good. Oh, and a blaze. Oh, so I wonder if we should test this fire thing. Should we? Should we? You go away. All right. Hit us, Mr. Blaze. Hit us. I think the skelly hit us, not the blaze. Oh, why would you hit us when we want you to hit us? Come on, Blaze. There we go. Are we taking damage? No, we're not, are we? Excellent. Yes. Oh, but you. Oh, but we still are about to die because we're out of health. I just came back through the portal and there's blazes in here, in the portal. Oh. They set everything on fire too. Oh, hey, you. Is there anything burning? There's nothing burning. Oh, lucky it's raining. All right, yes, back at base, guys. I only actually found those two chests, so I'm not sure what's going on there. Whether the chests have been reduced in the Nether fortresses there. But okay, drop of evil, necrotic bone, withered rib. And wither dust. These all came from wither skeletons. So lots of wither skeleton goodies. Now let's try these little action figures. Can we right click in here to change gender? Can we actually place them? This action figure will now spawn a male gender. This action figure will now spawn a female gender. Okay, it's not something you place in the world then. Okay, we'll put that away. What about this skull? Can we place this? No. Okay. Can we use it for anything? No. All right. We'll have to leave that for whenever we investigate Jurassic Craft. Yeah. All right. Let's head off. And of course, it's raining when we gonna we want to go exploring. Now we're going to head off initially, guys. So we're here. There's our little patches there of crystals. So when we were explored around this way last time, I think we'll head down and see what this swamp thing is all about. It looks very swampy. All right, I've made it to the swamp, guys, but it's sun is setting, so we could use our sleeping bag here, but we've got this little. What is it? A small Bedouin from nomadic tents. So let's put him down there. Ooh, look at that. And we have this super tent mallet. So if we click on that, or hit him like this, or hit him like this. Oh, hit him there. Okay. And it makes a little tent. Okay. Can we go in? We click the door. And here we are. We're in a tent, which is really dark. All right, little 5x5 tent with a 3x3 spot. I should have built a big one. Basically, this nomadic tent. Nomadic, nomadic, nomadic. Nomadic JEI, yes, this. Okay. I built this little guy, a small Bedouin. So it's built with these things, which is basically just wool and sticks. So you don't actually need very much to make these tents. And now we can sort of spend the night here. Now you saw there was a bit of a load screen there. We're actually in another dimension. So I think we can actually place things down in this little tent and Let's see if we put that down like that. And maybe a chest. And then I think we can leave and then break the tent, and this stuff will stay in the tent, which will be very handy. All right, let's test that. In here, out here, is it still dark? We might still have to sleep through the night. I'm not sure if it, yeah, okay. Right, so we could put a bed down in there, although there's not really much space for a bed in here. If we sleep in a sleeping bag, maybe? Sleep through the night, and then we'll go out, break the tent, and see what happens. yeah, there we are. Click through we go. And there we are. And let's see, can we. How do we break the tent? Like this? Like this? Or like this? Like this? Oh, there we are. Click the door. Okay, so we've got our tent. So if we place that down again, just maybe somewhere over here, like that, and then build it again. There we are. Go in again. And it's still here. Excellent. Okay, so we can carry stuff around in our tent. Very handy. Now, apart from that, there's not much here in this swamp. There's a tree on fire. These little rocky things here are full of lava. So, yeah, they're setting the swamp on fire. Now, it says swampland under the map there that you probably can't see on YouTube, but because we are using biome bundle, which uses terrain control, we can type TC biome. Terrain control is not enabled for this world. Yes, it is. That's interesting. Well, it is enabled for this world, funnily enough, given that this terrain is not actually vanilla terrain and these trees aren't vanilla trees. So, not sure what's going on there, and there's redstone on the surface. All right, let's head off out that way. We might have to jump in a boat. I just heard lots of thunder and lightning and things with no storm happening, and there's this building here. So, what's all this about? Oh, look, it's our buddy, the Ferris Rotnaught. We saw him in our last episode of Ob's Worlds, but there was something else in here. Oh, what is that? Oh, what are these things? Running. Oh, luckily we don't catch fire, isn't it? Wither Skelly? What's that doing here? Oh, fast Wither Skelly. Oop, or is that just word lag for the world loading? What are you? Something from Voidcraft, which doesn't have a proper translation, and you killed us. I'm gathering from this Void Wrath from Voidcraft. Interesting. Guys, don't eat canola seeds raw because that happens. Ugh. Okay, I got back, guys, and my stuff is still there, and they despawned, but it's just started doing thunder and lightning again, so possibly that thing, Voidcraft stuff, is coming back. So let's run away, run away, run away. Guys, I headed out into the water just on a good old vanilla boat, and things are happening. There's purple flame over there. That might be another one of those Voidcraft things. So we might just continue on out this direction, and it's dark and it's raining. Let's find a spot to camp. Okay, I just had a crash, guys, and I've logged back in, and now that the water here is green, so I think something happened, maybe going to the Nether and coming back. So yeah, now we're actually back. The terrain control seems happy again, so it's coloured the water. And it tells us that we're in a mangrove forest biome, so we can type in TC slash TC biome, and it'll tell us the terrain control biome because it uses its own biome system. So much better looking now that it's green. Yeah, hopefully that crash I had doesn't happen again. But there is a structure over here. There's some stone bricks. Oh, my driving's poor. Boat driving poor. Okay. Oop. Ooh, all right. Now, there's a spawner. There's a spider spawner. Okay. Quick, is there a chest though? I want a chest. Oh, there's a chest there. Can we reach it? She is? No, she is. Bummer. Let's just dig then. Okay. Okay. Gold, potatoes. Yeah. Okay. Vanillary stuff in there. And he's not spawning, maybe, because he's too bright. Good. Let's go away. Oh, there's these two little shiny things. Chaos node. Chaos node. Oh, and there's a slime island. What do we do with these guys? Do we. Well, we'll break one, seeing there's two. Can we break it? Nope. Not sure what. Oop! What was that? I heard click, click, click or something. Is that those chaos nodes? Something to look into, guys. Oh, hang on. And our buddies are back. Our other buddies. We had the Ferris Rortnaut earlier. And, oh, come on, world load. Yeah, the world loading is pretty bad, I think. It's very, very slow. These guys haven't reacted yet. G'day, fellas. There they go. Oh, and they're hurting us. Right, yes, they're hurting away. Bow. I did get a bow, guys. I finally made a bow. Oh, but he's blocking it with his shield. Oh, man. Running, running. Oh, running, 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 running. Oh, he's still there. Oh, you are sneaky. Oh, yeah. Keep missing him. Oh, you're pretty clever, aren't you? Oh, don't slam, don't spam, slam, spam. Ah. Oop. 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 There we are. Oop. Yeah. Oop. Ah! Oh, the other guys came in and got us. Ah, cool. Just back at spawn point, guys, and I'm starting to think I might need to turn on keep inventory because, yeah, this is getting a little wearing, me being silly and dying all the time. So I would like to know if there's something in any of the mods we've got, just from the mods you've seen already, guys. If you know of something that we can make or craft or something that'll let us keep all our inventory when we die, let me know in the comments. Otherwise, I might think about turning it on. Yeah, I just walked into another Mousy's mob thing. That guy and that guy. Yes. So yes, guys, we do have Mousy's mobs in 110. We saw the Ferris Rortnaut and the little dudes in the plains there. So yeah, fun guys. I just found one of these things, guys. Another one because I wanted to get some food, and then I accidentally stood on a pressure plate, and there's these block breakers here. So the three of these things just got broken. So I don't know if they're actually still in the block breakers. You don't know how to use this object. So I haven't researched it. So Future Pack has some research as well. Ah, interesting though. I'm going back a slightly different way to where we died goes. I'm skirting the swampy bits down there, but there's some interesting mountains and a little bowl shape down there, which is quite nice. I nearly got my stuff, and now there's one of these guys. Oh, it is just a skelly, but the fallen knights there from Ender Zoo. So, and they hurt a lot. Oh, and what are those little guys running around there? Oh, he's running away again. I can't get all my stuff. I've got too much full inventory. Oh, you go away. Ow, 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 ow. Whop. Oh, I'm gonna die again. No, 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 no. Don't do silly things like charge skellies. Whew, oh, and put that helmet on. Oh, I'll get me stuff back, hopefully. Right, okay. So what are these guys? Armadillos. We'll leave them. We'll let them go. And I spotted those other little guys again that got us before, but I think they've wandered off. So we'll just. Oop, there's some over there. Yeah, we'll avoid them until we get better gear, I think. Oh, hang on a minute. So Mousy's mobs. He's got it. This. I think he's a Sun King or something over there.
Regina.
Oh, 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 he, oh, okie dokie. Aha. Yeah, we might avoid him for the moment now, guys, until we gear up, but we'll keep an eye on this. I'll put a waypoint on here, and we'll return here in good time. All right, I think there's a village here too, which is good. Our first village. Okay, let's see. What have we got? A village? A village. I'm hearing villages. Oop, can we get our way up there? There we go. This is like, this doesn't look like a very vanilla little building though, does it? This must be another mod, I think. Oh, hello. You are a jam guy. Oh, actually additions. Okay. Ah, for home co jam. Blah, 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 blah. I can't pronounce your jams there, mate. But, ooh, and oh, there's some floating over here. Oops. Let's grab those. And what's in here? More jams. Okay. Plenty of jams. We'll have to look into those. And some bottles. What's out the back here? One of those. That'll hurt us, but nothing else. Okay. What else you got, mate? You stay in there. You be good. Actually, if we get rid of this, maybe he won't walk out. And put that there. Let's block him in. What's over here? Another one. Door is probably down here somewhere. Maybe? Somewhere? Ah, yes, over here. Okay. What do we got in here? We have nothing. But these guys. What have we got here? Ooh, you've got... Oh, a druid. He's got red eyes there. Look at that. Okay, just regular old trades there. Butcher. Okay. What else? What else? There's got to be some other interesting things here somewhere. There we are. We'll lock those guys in just so they don't get out and things don't get in. This village, town, thing, house, that's the word. some more guys around there. You look like just a cleric. What about in here? Regular one. Yeah, cleric. Okay. You over here. Whoop, running away. Come back, druid. Another druid. I wonder what trades they have if we unlock it. They could have some interesting stuff. Oh, you look pretty familiar. The apiarist from forestry. Very cool. Lots of harvest craft things in the... not in that one, but over in this one. Yeah, plenty of different crops. In here, nothing. Okay, down here, nothing. Over here, nothing. Leather worker and butcher. Another jam guy. Aha, railcraft one. With nothing. railcraft might still be working on its updates. Ooh, yes, you see the bit of lag there with the world generation here. Those guys just arrived. they're after us. I'm sure one of the ones with that sort of green-looking mask, I think that seems to be new. I don't recognise that one from the 1.7.10 version. Whew. Okay, let's try one of these ones. Jams. Poor apple jam. Blindness. Oh, and haste, though. Small price to pay for a bit of haste, maybe when we go mining. Okay. Come on, go away. Good. And what was the other one? Pico jam. Yeah, what's this one going to do? Oop. Oh, nausea, but speed. Nausea. Hate nausea. Oh, I think our tent's gone a bit funny. Because... he's one of him. Yeah, it seems to be missing door and things seem to be in the wrong spot. Yeah, that's not a good sign, is it? Luckily, we didn't have anything valuable in there at the moment. Oop. diamonds on the surface. Love that. a forest poplar biome. This is an interesting one. There's pumpkins in amongst the trees here. Are they pumpkins or jack-o'-lanterns? Jack-o'-lanterns. Ah, that would look really cool at night, wouldn't it? Throughout this sort of jungly type one. What's this one? Jungle edge. but there's quite a few of those little pumpkins there. Jack-o'-lanterns. Oh, and lots of melons. Lots and lots of melons. Ooh, down onto a big beach there. This looks like there's a bit of a structure down there. Yeah, let's go have a look at that. See if there's any goodies in there. Hidden away. Or not hidden away. Yeah, it looks like almost like a witch's hut, doesn't it? But sort of abandoned and things. Oh, good. Look at that. That's handy. any goodies? There's a crafting table, but doesn't look like there's any chests, does there? Ah, bummer. Ooh, but there is a couple of things. There's another future craft thing here, but with different colours. Not sure if that means it's any different or not. But there's also this big square thing over here, and another chest on the beach there too. Ooh, more goodies. So what's all this about? Nature core, random things. Oop. Oh, we got a bit of lag. I'm guessing that that's lag. Are we gonna try again? Or maybe it's the nature's core putting something in. I don't know really. I don't really know what that is. Do we break it with something? Well, I'm looking at the thing on the top right. It says no tool with a cross on it. Can we not break this? Ooh, no. Okay. Do we sort of right click it or axe? No. Underneath. Do we break everything around it? Does that do something? Get all out of the way. Does this do something? No. It's a wild guess. No. Okay, guys, if you know what that is, let me know in the comments. However, there's this chest right next to it that has magic beans, saplings, and other bits. We're from. So that's a magic beans random. Random things, magic beans. So that comes from that. So maybe that's just a marker for this chest. I wonder what these things are. And I'll take some of this too. This teal clay from Ob's Machines. I just came down this future craft thing again, and basically it's the same thing. So more goodies, just different colours here. Just the orange colour instead. But I will grab some of it because it could be good for decoration. There's a very, very big mountain range spawning in there. It's got lots of white in it. I wonder if it's a lot of diorite put into it. Looks very cool though. Well, it's just walking along the this mountain here. The big mountain we saw earlier is just over there. But look down there. There's something in the water down there, and over this way, there's something in the air up there. So yeah, but I think we'll head down. See what's down in the water down there. There's a little entrance there. I'm gathering its future pack. It looks very future packy. Fluffy puff seas. Oh, there you go. So we'll head over down into that entrance and have a look what's down there. Okay, oh, I can see guardians in the water down over there. But let's head down, blue this time, down these ladders, see what this is all about. It's very, oop. Oh, there's another crystal thing here, and then there's this green thing. I don't know if this is related or not. Let's keep going down the stairs, though. Okay, oh, maybe this is just another thing here that's not actually. Oh, is it very dark in there? Is that part of whatever we're seeing? Torches would be helpful. Oh, by the way, guys, there was a pressure plate here with some redstone and some block breakers under there, which I've picked up there. And there was lava in these little spots underneath it. So I'm gathering the block breakers, broke the wardrobe things, and then dropped them into the lava there. Very sneaky. Oh, and one other quick thing, guys. You can put wardrobes in wardrobes. Very handy. Except when you break it, it drops the wardrobes. very clever. Well, I've only got three torches, guys, so it's a bit dark at the moment. I don't know if this is actually going to lead anywhere. Are we actually heading in the right direction? Oh, that's that stuff. I was hoping to get some coal. Funnily enough, we need coal. And that's a dead end. Okay. Well, I can't see any obvious way in there, guys. There's something underneath us here if we just drop out of the boat. This thing. It sort of goes into the mountain there, so maybe I'll dig into the mountain and see if we can get in through that way. Well, found a little cave, so maybe we might just dig our way in, I think. See if we can do that. Oh, yes, let's do that. Find out what we've got here. So lots of metal, and lots of junk in our inventory. I might have to ditch some of these Oh, and you go away. There's some other goodies I just saw out of a corner of my eye there, guys. Alright, so what do we got here? Oh, more wardrobes. Got so many wardrobes. Oh, that one looks different though. Gold coils. Ventilation. Just the slabs. More goodies. Okay, I'll grab some of these coils. Oh, and copper parts. You just sort of don't know, is this something that's really easy to craft when we do the research? But we'll take them anyway. Okay. Consolidated those wardrobes a bit. This way? Oh, what have we got here? Oh, more wardrobes. More stuff. Oh, magic capacitor. Oh, it's Ender IO. Huh. Okay. So it looks like we've got regular old loot in there. Okay. Nothing. Bits. Bits. Bits, bits. Oh, shiny bits, frozen cores. Oh, and a whole bunch over here too. Ooh, bees. Goodies. I'm sure we've gone well over time, guys. I'll probably edit out some of the Nether visits, seeing and the Nether is just the Nether. But we got one of these weapon case loot. So I think we just right click like that. And it rattles through like almost like a roulette wheel or something. And we got the Ruby. 4th edition case loot. Common provides resistance 1. Okay, so I gather we can put that there somewhere. So we've got resistance. And we also got this, an antidote charm from Cyclic. So I gather... Oh, auto cure, poison, and wither. Oh, awesome. Okay, definitely want that. You know what, guys? We might just... we'll come back to all of this other stuff... soon, but we better keep looking around. Given there's lots of these. Ooh, it goes down and there's grass and things down there. Oh, hello zombie. Yeah, we might have to continue on with this in the next episode. I'm sure we're well over time. I haven't really checked, given there's all these cases everywhere. Whew. Yeah. Alright. Ooh, goodies, goodies. Tech table. You don't know how to use it. Ooh, but it looks interesting. And more, another tech table. Okay. Oh, I want to keep exploring, guys. You, go away. Oop. Ooh. Ooh, so a lot of blah, blah, blah experience. Yeah, guys, we are massively over time. I might keep recording, but it'll be the next episode where you see where we continue on with this. I might have to get some episodes out with pretty quickly in a row, I think. So I hope you enjoyed it, guys. We'll keep exploring this building in the next episode. See you then.